So total, how many examples done here? 4 examples, right? Example 5. So I'll give you a small requirement. Try to do the requirement here. Try to do the requirement. Take the employee ID, employee name, employee salary from end user. From end user, right? Good. So employee ID, employee name, employee salary from which one here? End user, right? Good. Then print the data simply. You print the data, right? That's it. So just to pause this video, you can please try to complete this code. The in front of the video, don't sit idle. Excuse me. So in front of the video, don't sit idle. Okay, so now you can pause the video, you can start writing this code, right? Good. So now here, how to take the code here? Employee ID, employee name, employee salary from the keyboard, right? Employee ID means I want integer data. You simply can go for the input function. Input, simply can go for the enter employee ID, right? So here you can take the EID format. Next one is want, simply can go for the ename here. So employee name in which format? String required, right? String means input function or input function. You can go for the both. Input means if you enter the data, that will take the input format. Raw input also you can take, right? Raw input function. Raw input function, enter employee name, right? The last one is what? Employee salary. Whatever employee salary here, you can go for the input. So input, simply can go for the enter employee salary, right? That's it. He entered some salary. Then I want print this data. To print the data, simply print the print the data means what? Print EID. So one by one means what? Print EID. Come here, print EID. Otherwise, simply can go for the employee ID equal to comma EID. Next one is what? Employee name equal to comma E name. Last one is what? Employee salary equal to employee salary equal to what? E salary, right? That's it. No other sir, I want print the three values in the single line. Print employee ID comma employee name comma employee salary. No other sir, I want to print by using format function. If you are print by using format function, simply can go for the printer. Print what? So here employee ID equal to, you can enter the variances, zero index value. Zero index value, next one is what? Employee name equal to, parenthesis one index value. Last one is what? Employee salary. Tell me, employee salary equal to. So index is what? 3. So data, simply can go for the format function. Format of how many index are there here? 0, 1, 2, right? Here simply can pass that variable. Employee ID, employee name. The last one is what? Employee salary, right? That's it. I hope clear, right? Good. Simply can run this code once. So here, so Python first.py, enter employee ID, employee name directly can enter. So here single code is not required because input takes the string only, right? If you take any type of data, enter employee salary 10,000.45. Now you can check the data. Why it's saying error message? When you see the error message, feel happy, right? So it's saying index error 0, 1, 2. Errors are very, very simple because the compiler is showing proper messages, right? The reason here 0, 1, here we have to give what 2, right? But they're giving 3. Errors are very, very important. Mainly focus on error. Employee table 1, employee name button, enter employee salary 10,000 points on 56, right? That's it. Now we can check it. Employee equal 111, employee name equal Ratan, employee salary 111. Printing the three variables in single line, right? 111 Ratan, 10,000.56. Employee equal 111, employee name Ratan, and employee salary is over 10,000.56, right? That's it. Clear us. This is the example I said. Okay. See, once you focus on topic, we have to complete the topic. That's it. Now in this video, what you are focusing, how to take the input from the keyboard, right? So at the up to end of the video, then decide, okay, I'm perfecting to take the input from the keyboard, right? Like that, you can take the input. Sir, this is exam number how much here? Exam number 5, right? That's it. Clear up to now? Good. So actually, one small point here. Now we have a Python, up to now we are taking input from the keyboard, right? This is up to Python 2.7 only. Up to Python 2.7, to take the input from the keyboard, we have input function of what? Raw input function. But now present question is what? Python 3, right? From the Python 3 onwards, we have only one function to take the input. Which function is there here? Input function, right? Where we have only which function? Input function, right? That's it. But coming to the input function, so what is the input? What is the Python 2.7? 2.7 input function, it takes any type of data. It means if you enter the integer data, means it takes integer. If you enter the string data, means it takes string. If you enter the float data, means it will take what? Float, right? Raw input function will take only which data? String data. But coming to Python 3, Python 3 input function will act as Python 2.7 raw input function. Python 3 input function will behave like a raw input in Python 2. It means what is the raw input will take here? String data, right? Python 3 input function will act as Python 2 raw input function. It means what? The input function also will take which data here? Only string data, right? Sir, my takes only which data here? Takes only which data here? String data, right? That's it. You clear? So in Python 3, the raw input input function will take only which data here? String data. So if you want, you can check it. But in my system, I said Python is what? 2.7, right? But I want 3.0. If you want Python 3.0, I'll go for the online compiler. Simply can go for the Google Chrome. So in the Google Chrome, let me open the online compiler. Good. Online compiler. That's it. In online compiler, what do we do here? So say Python, Python compiler. So then it's asking repl.it. Then the Python online compiler is open. So it is asking email password. So go to the first one here, directly the time you open. Yeah, that's it. So here this is a Python 3.6 compiler actually. Okay, but here my command prompt is the 2.7, right? Good. Let me write the code here. In Python 3, the input function, will take one which data here? String data, right? Good. Let me write the code here. Let me write the code here. So I'm taking number 1 equal to, simply going to go for the input function. Input of, let me increase the size here once. Yeah, input of. So simply going to go for the enter first number, right? So number 1. Like that. Oh, come on. So enter the second number. So it takes this even what? Input 2, right? Good. Add equal to number 1 plus number 2, right? Good. But this is the Python 3. Python 3 means to print the data out of the parentheses. Otherwise, previously I'm using like this, right? You can do that operation once. Addition, comma, here add. But showing error message, right? Read the error message here. Missing parentheses in call to print, right? It means what? 2.7, the parentheses optional. But 3.0, the parentheses are mandatory. Take this data in the parentheses. Okay, good. So here simply run this code. It is asking enter first number, enter 10, enter second number 20. It sees how much here? 10 and 20. Why? The input function will take such data here. String data, right? That's it. This is a Python. Python which version here? Python. Tell me 3.0, right? This is my example number how much? Example number 6, right? That's it. This is the Python 3.0, 3.6 you can say, that's it. Okay, good. And example number 7, as usual, simply can go for the type conversion, right? What about type conversion? The tempo is okay or feeling bored? Don't feel bored, focus on subject, right? That's it. So can we subscribe to my channel, we get the more videos. Type conversion, how to think, what is number 7? See, always I'll focus on practicals. Don't write always writing. It's not required. Mainly how to focus on what? Practice. See, tell me one thing. You need the practical as a theoretical knowledge. Explanation of the code more times, that is not recommended, right? Sir, my explanation of more time on the code is not recommended. Simply can go for what? Practicals, right? See, once you do the practicals, you get the more feeling, right? So here feeling important. So type conversion in the middle, if you feel boring, can please stop the video, go to movie, that's it. Yes, sir, no, yeah. what will be feeling at the boring? Feel comfortable. Okay, so try to get the subject. That's it. Every day do one video. That's it. But here Python 3 it will take such a data here, string data, right? But I want conversion process means I said here directly can do the conversion. Typecast which format here? Integer format. Here also simply can go for which format? Integer format. So here I'm typing integer format, right? That's it. Simply run this code here. Enter first number 100 and second number 200. It is how much here? 300, right? It is how much here? 300, right? That's it. This is called what? Type conversion process, right? Sir, no, yeah. This is called what? Type conversion, right? That's it. Exam number 8. Exam number 8. Right here, the small point. I'll run this code once again. In your system, if the Python is not installed, so ready-made code means what? You can go to the online compiler. Enter first number, enter the number, okay, so 10, enter the first number, enter what, 10, right, that is okay, no problem, but I enter number 20.5, 10.5 is which format, float format, but I am typecasting which format, integer format, right, then tell me, which error will you get, think once, which error will you get, which error will get? Value error, right? That's it. Simply run this code. Oh, come on here. You have to click an enter button. You're running the click and run button. Enter first number 10. Enter second number is what? 10.5, right? We'll get the error is what? Value error. Sir, no. That's it. So here you can do the typecasting here itself. Otherwise, one more way is what? After taking the data, right? Here number 1 I want it converted to format, number 2 integer format. No, here we have to take the number 2 within the brackets, right? Number 2 within the brackets, here number 1 take within the brackets. I want it converted to which format here, float format, right? That's it. Right, clear? Simply run this code once. Number 1 integer format, number 2 float format, 20.6. Output is what? What happened here? Okay. Reverse process we are doing, I think. Number 1 is the integer format, right? Okay, once again you can run it. What's the problem? Enter first number. We have to take the first number is a float format. That is no problem. Second number you are converting which format here? Integer format, right? 10. 20.6, right? That's it. So while doing the type conversion, mainly we have to focus on one error. What is the error here? Type value error, right? That's it. Okay, which error will get here? Value error, right? That's it. Very clear. So that's all about how many examples we done here. 8 examples. This is also what a type conversion, right? That's it. This is all about what a how to take the input from what end user. What example one you are taking? Input function. Input function. It will take the data. Which data we entered? In the case 1, we entered which data here? Tell me, in the case 1, we entered which data here? Integer data, right? Good. In the case 2, we entered which data? This is the case 2. Case 2, we entered which data here? Float data, right? Good. What about case 3 here? Case 3, we entered which data here? String data, right? That's it. Case 4, we taking the both terms. 10 and 10.5, both are what? Number data only, right? Number data. Sir, no. Case 5, it is not possible to combine two different types of data. So we can combine only which type of data? Only same type of data, right? You can don't forget that point. Second example, we will focus on raw input function. Raw input function will take only which data here? String data. Then we have to convert it which format here? Type conversion required. Integer format or float format. Integer format means here directly can type as integer format. Integer format. So next example also type conversion. Here number 1 I'm converting which format here? Float format. Number 2 I'm converting which format here? Integer format, right? That's it. Example 5 I said just like asserted format. So it takes the employee name, employee cell from the end user, print the data, right? Good. Then we discuss Python 2.7 versus Python 3.6 and 3.6. So in Python 3 we have one which function here, input function to take the data. In Python 3, input will act as a Python 2 raw input function, right? It means in Python 3, the input function, it will take only string data. String data means what? Once again, you have to go for the type conversion process, right? While type conversion, mainly we have to focus on one error. What is that error here? Value error, right? That's it. Very clear, but next one is what? Exam number 9 you can take. So this is also simply resident format, take the data. Take the student ID, already we taken this data, like employee. Same you can write this code, student ID, student name, student marks, from the end user, from the end user, print the data, that's it, print the data. But I am not writing this example, you guys can write it. Exam number 10 is what? Exam number 10 here. So give, I want that an addition operation. Take the two decimal values from the keyboard. So take the, like end user, take the two decimal values, take the two decimal values from what? From the key, from the end user, right? Take the two decimal values from the end user, and I want addition in the integer format. Add in which format? Into format. I hope clear, right? Take the two decimal values from the keyboard, and the data in which format here? Integer format, I want the data. The data in which format I want? Integer format, right? That is my requirement. Can please do this requirement, okay? Take the two decimal values from the keyboard, add the data in which format here? Integer format, right? Can you please pause this video? Can please do this requirement? Right? Good. So I will do this one here. You can check it. Take the two decimal values. So enter first number, enter second number. Okay, enter second number, first number and what? Second number, right? So then here we have typecast which format here? Integer format. Okay, we have to convert which format here? Integer format, right? That's it. So in this here, just take the student ID, student name, student marks from the end user and print the data, right? That's it. Just like this is employee ID, employee name, employee salary, right? That's it. Just I'm changing variable names, right? That's it. Okay, clear on this? So that's it. Thanks for watching. So don't forget the 4 points. You can please like the video, share the video, which one? Like the video, write the comment, subscribe, right? Sorry, no, yeah. Great. Can please improve the popularity, right? That's it. So let me repeat all the points here from top to bottom here. Example 1 onwards. Example 1, to take the input, we are using here input function. So if you enter the integer database, integer data. If you enter the decimal database, decimal value. String database, string. Number database, addition is possible. If you enter the number plus string means, it is not possible to combine the two different data types. What is the example to be done here? Raw input function. The raw input function always takes the data in which format here? String format. Then we done type conversion process, right? That's it. The fourth example also type conversion process. So value error, right? Why you get the value error here? Value error here. So if expecting integer means what? So float means what? So integer means you have to type, you have to give only integer value. But he entered what? Decimal value, right? 10.5. So it's saying valid value error, invalid literal for integer with base 10, but 10.5, right? That's it. Example 5 is what? Take the input from the keyboard, employee ID, employee name, employee salary. Then Python 2 versus Python 3. Python 2, to take the input, we have two options, input function and raw input function. But in Python 3, to take the input, So here we have the input function, right? That's it. The Python 3 input function will act as raw input in Python 3. It means what? Python 3 input, it takes only which data? String data, right? Then you can do the type conversion process. For the exam number 1 here, student ID, take the data from the end user, print the data, right? That's it. Thank you guys. Thanks for watching. You can please like the video, subscribe the videos. And what? Write the comment, right? Clear? That's it.
Thank you, guys.